Howdy, my name is Nonat. Usually, I do more informative videos, but today is strictly for entertainment purposes. That, and to finally get this story out in the open. It's one of those RPG stories that has just kind of sat dormant for years. Not for any negative reason, it just kind of hid in the back of my mind for the last 4 or 5 years, until it just popped back up and I decided to share it with you guys. Some quick background. I've been playing tabletop RPGs for about 6 years now. I started in college during my freshman year. Well, technically that's not true. I did play a bit in high school, but whew, that's a story for another day. This story actually takes place during my sophomore year of college. It was the first semester, so my friends and I were still pretty brand new to tabletop RPGs. It was that fun period where none of us knew what we were doing, but we were all so desperately interested that we'd play whenever we got the chance. I was, and still am, completely in love with the idea of playing the Game Master, so I asked my friends, "Hey, do you want to start a campaign?" And luckily, they all said sure. Up to this point, the only game system I had played was Pathfinder 1st Edition. I didn't know anything about D&D 3.5 or 5th Edition or Call of Cthulhu or any of that jazz. So we talk it over as a group, and we all decide, "You know what's a great idea? What if we run an evil campaign?" And all of us collectively are like, "Yeah, that's badass, this will be awesome." So our group comes together, three players and myself. The three players, who all call Jason, Theo, and Scoot. I don't know why I'm hiding their names, they wouldn't care if I told the story, but I'm doing it anyway. Also, I was going to call him Scott, but I misspelled it Scoot in my script, so we're sticking with that. So there we were in the college dormitory basement. Dice at the ready, rulebooks in hand, prepared to start our evil campaign. Jason rolled up a monk, Theo made a rogue, and Scoot created a summoner with a massive flying snake eidolon. Let's pause for a moment so I can tell you about evil campaigns. In order for them to work, all of the characters must have a reason to work together. Especially if you have chaotic evil characters, they need to have a reason to be forced to work together. Now, 17-year-old Nonat was honestly pretty clever. The three level 1 characters were all simultaneously transported into the lair of a lich, and this lich demanded they work for him in exchange for power and riches, and also their lives, as he'd kill them if they refused. Yeah, it was definitely a bit of a railroad, but when it's an evil campaign, you almost have to. I still believe that, kinda to this day. So they agree to work for the lich, and their first task was to find some sacred documents in a holy cathedral. So the lich warps them out of his lair and into the middle of the cathedral. They sneak their way through a hallway, and luckily, undetected. From there, they were able to sneak their way through the main chambers and find the holy documents on top of the pastor's podium. Scoot, the summoner, walks forward, reaches out, and takes them. However, upon touching these papers, a blinding light filled the room, and what was left standing in front of these level 1 characters was a level 9 holy paladin with a greatsword decked out in full plate armor. Now obviously, I didn't expect them to fight him. And while I'm sure you would all want to hear about how they charged headfirst into battle, they actually didn't. They all ran away as fast as they could. Luckily, I think I painted the picture of this guy strong enough that they thought, "We're not supposed to fight that, let's go the other way." So the three of them ran out into the winding hallways of the cathedral. It was at this point, looking out one of the open cathedral windows, they realized they were roughly 8 stories up off the ground, so they couldn't just jump out. With the thumping of the paladin's boots getting closer, they booked it and found a large spiral staircase. Making their way down, they noticed that there was an exit onto each floor as they descended the stairs. For reasons that I will never fully understand, Scoot decides it's a good idea to just take one of these exits. You know, instead of running all the way down to the ground floor. So he splits and runs down a different hallway as Theo and Jason keep running down the stairs. So we're about 45 minutes into my first ever GM session, and my party has already split up. Great. So let's focus on Jason and Theo first. They climb down the 8 floors of stairs and make their way to the front entrance. The good news was that there was nobody guarding the front door of the cathedral. The bad news was that the only way out was through the very open and exposed courtyard, which led to a large iron gate. This gate was also secured by 2 level 5 guards. I want to talk about Jason and Theo's characters here. First off, Theo was a very animated guy. He was a ton of fun to play with, and admittedly, giving him the option to make a chaotic evil rogue is entirely on me. But this character was... well, he was just insane. Quite literally. At this point, while Jason is just analyzing the courtyard for an escape, Theo just... starts walking. Yeah, he just starts strolling through the courtyard towards the gate, completely nonchalant. Now, Jason had never played or even really seen a tabletop RPG before. Since it was his first time playing and he didn't want to feel too silly, he decided to make his monk silent. He didn't want to do a voice and roleplay, so his monk had taken a vow of silence and never spoke a word, only communicating through head nods and hand motions. Fair enough. But this meant he could not communicate with Theo's character as he just walked away through the courtyard right up to the guards.
"Hello," he said to the guards. "I'd like to leave, please."
At this, the guards blocked his path and, very confused, replied with,
"You don't look like you belong here. How'd you get inside?"
Theo just smiles and says,
"Well, I walked in and now I'm walking out. So if you'll excuse me."
The guards, of course, continue to prevent him from leaving and keep asking him questions. After about 30 seconds of this, Theo just says,
"Oh well, I tried."
He pulls out his dagger and makes an attack roll. And misses. Combat begins. Jason, of course with no other option, sprints out into the fray, and the two of them start taking on 2 level 5 guards at level 1. Now let's back up a little bit and take a look at Scoot. Now, especially being less agile than the monk and the rogue, Scoot the summoner begins to fall behind, so he takes a random exit on the stairs. He spends the next little while just running through hallways, taking turns, and, as we remember, Scoot was the one who took the holy documents, so the magical summoned paladin is slowly coming specifically after him. Also, the players don't necessarily know this, but that paladin would have killed any of them in one hit. Not just knocked unconscious, but outright... So after about a minute of running around, Scoot takes a chance and ducks into a random room. He closes the door behind him and relaxes for a brief moment. The room is fairly simple and has a very clear purpose. Across from the door Scoot entered through, there was a massive window. No glass, just a wide, clear opening in the cathedral wall. And set up inside this window was a full-sized ballista. This was clearly designed to ward off intruders coming from the front. Looking through this large window, of course, Scoot sees 2 scrawny little characters fighting and very quickly losing to 2 heavily armored guards. So initiative resumes from there. Theo and Jason are clearly outclassed and losing health. Theo the rogue falls unconscious, and Jason is barely alive. And then the game pauses. It's Scoot's turn, and he's thinking. And he says a sentence that I will never forget. "I load my summon into the ballista." I kind of stare at him, thinking, I don't... And he says it again. "I load my summon into the ballista." And I just say, okay. You load your summon into the ballista. And at this point, we're all starting to laugh. And after like a full minute of just like laughing and not knowing what to do, we finally ask the serious question of how does this work? What are the rules for firing a giant flying snake eidolon out of a ballista? And the short answer is that there is none. So I did what any good GM would do at a time like this. I look Scoot dead in the eye and say, "I'm going to roll 1d20. If I roll anything but a natural 20, your shot misses, and Theo and Jason are screwed. But judging by the fact that I'm telling this story, you all know exactly what happened next. Scoot lined up the shot and fired. His giant snake Eidolon flung at an insane velocity and absolutely eradicated both guards in the courtyard. They erupted in a bloody mess of viscera, and of course the Eidolon died alongside them from the damage of the impact. Theo lays unconscious but alive, Jason is bleeding horribly, and all of us are cheering and laughing that this crazy crackpot plan actually worked. I wish the story ended here, but there isn't really a happy ending for our heroes. Shortly after firing the shot, the door to Scoot's room opened, and the paladin stepped inside, closing in on him. This, sadly, is where we ended the game for the first session, and due to time constraints, other games popping up, and college, we never returned to this one. The game was an absolute mess. We got half of the rules wrong, and it was when I truly fell in love with role-playing games. Thank you for watching.